breached the walls. I must find Shelbert.
Have you seen Shelbert?
No, but we caught sight of Leovi fleeing across the river. He was chasing someone.
It has to be Shelbert. He's the only prize worth taking in this mud sink.
Jailbeard. He's in trouble.
I won't back down, Leofrith. I will not. Don't make this hard in the past.
Please, you do not want to do this.
Leofrith, let him walk. You answer to me.
I answer to my king. Our silence deigns with this.
Lay it by, Leofrith. There's nothing left to fight for. We've stormed Repton. Only a matter of time.
I cannot do that.
Then you will die.
Someone will.
You can't win this, Leofrith. Even if you defeat me, the Ragnarsons have won the day.
I have fought many a day in my time. I'm still standing.
Slowing. Bah. You're a strong-willed thane. Burgred was lucky.
To stand in the way of you and Mercia is my duty. I will die before I yield.
You're finished.
Not yet. Fight me, heathen!
No appeal to your god? Or your king?
I swore an oath to serve Burgred to the death. I fought. I lost. We both know how this goes.
An honorable thane fighting a dishonorable war.
Burgred abandoned him, betrayed his trust. If I were Leofrith, I'd want to know.
Why rob him of this last glory? A warrior ready to meet his god and bask in his praise. To live will only lead him to shame.
It's not an oath he would keep if he knew the truth.
Then choose. Truth or glory?
stand, Leofrith. Live to fight another day.
What?
Your loyalty to Burgred is not a loyalty returned. He resigned the crown and fled to Rome. He's gone.
You lie.
Lie to a man seconds from death. What would I gain? He saved himself and left you to die. All this fighting, it's for nothing. For no one. To betray one so trusted, so close. It's a dishonor worth a thousand deaths.
Eivor, you have shown me a great kindness. It is only fitting that I do the same. At Venonis, there is a statue with a scroll laid in a small bowl. You must burn it.
A scroll?
Your name is on this scroll. At Burgred's request, I put it there. When it is found, the zealots who read it will hunt you.
Who are they?
It doesn't matter now. You haven't much time. Burn the scroll, or they will never stop hunting you.
Where will you go now?
Rome.
Come on. Let's take you back. Careful. You're injured.
I'm all right, really. A few nicks and cuts from the battle, that's all.
These wounds will heal quickly. You're lucky.
I threw myself at him, Eivor. But he only toyed with me. He knew I couldn't touch him.
You should have stayed hidden, Chaelbert. This wasn't your fight.
It was. It was our fight. Yours, mine, my father's. I had to help.
And you did. You showed courage today. Bravery. You're a boy no longer.
Back there with Leofrith. I didn't think you'd spare him.
There is no honor in killing a man misled. He believed his king would die fighting for Mercia.
He knows the truth now.
And with that truth, he forged a new path. You were right about him, Chaelbert. And right to believe the line that divides us can be thinner than it seems.
Chaelbert! Look at you! Bloody and battle-worn. Could be chieftain of your own clan with courage like that.
No less than the King of Mercia, brother. One of these days.
And how is my father taking to his new role?
See for yourself.
You're an Oathlinger now. Or Aethling, I think you'd say. Next in line for the throne. It's an honorable title. One that demands good judgment. Be careful who you trust.
My son. Are you well?
Yes, father. Well enough.
He honored you today. Fought bravely against many stalwart foes.
You have my thanks. All of you. And my blessing.
Abba and Eva lost countless men in this fight. You want to show your thanks? Hold to your end of the bargain.
Of course. All of England will soon know that the Kingdom of Mercia has a new and powerful king.
The remaining kingdoms of England won't respect your path to power.
Nor will many in my kingdom. Burgred's soldiers will stand tall in the face of this turmoil, all across Mercia, against us.
That we shall remedy soon enough. I am riding for Oxenfordshire directly, to forge an alliance with some thanes there.
Shall I go with you?
Not till I know more. Linger here a while if you can. Strengthen our friendships. I will send for you soon enough.
Sigurd, I would feel better if Ceolbert was away from here until Mercia is more stable. Would you welcome him among your clan?
Do you have a horse, young Atheling?
I do. A young steed called Theobald.
Good. I can ride with you as far as the River Nene. You may find your way from there.
Thank you, Sigurd. This puts my mind at ease.
Be ready for my call, Eivor. It will come.
You and Sigurd make a good pair. The future of England will be pagan from top to bottom. Take this, Wolfgist, as a sign of friendship. And should you call, the brothers Ragnarsson will come.
You honor me, Abba.
See that? Sly bastard, trying to win your heart. Well, two can play at that game.
How kind of you, Ivar.
My pleasure. Our friendship is the best thing to come from this mess. Maybe Ceolbert too, the brave little twig.
That's good to hear. Now then, Leovrid said there are hunters after me. Zealots. If I don't clear my name, I'll be marked for death. I should head to Venonis. Now it seems the wind calls me back to Randvi. Best tell her the good news.
That's the statue of the Celots use. Done. Nothing but smoke and ashes now. That should get those Celots off my back. Your beggary is done, Tarpin. And our feasting table will be warmer for it.
Eivor, that is kind of you. I hope one day I can repay you.
You are among friends here. There is no need.
No need, but a desire. An earnest one. I remember the good things people do for me. To warm my heart in times when kindnesses are few and far between. There was one more thing, though, if you had a moment. A grain merchant has set up downriver. I want to bring a half dozen bags home, but I would need an extra pair of hands.
I can lend a hand.
That's a relief. I did not fancy asking Holger.
And a rival. I wonder if Valka's among them. Tarpin, what brought you to our clan?
Your reputation. Heard folk say a band of hard-drinking, battle-scarred warriors had washed up on shore. Said you had settled in the center of Mercia, taking in whatever flotsam, jetsam, and jumble of misfits came to your docks.
And this appealed to you?
More than anything. Always been a bit of a drifter. The thought of settling in a rowdy camp felt like a good balance. And being a baker, I knew my services would not be sniffed at.
Join battle together and reap glory's bounty.
Join me. Together we'll force open the doors of the Old Father's Hall. I did not take you for a baker when we met. You have the look of someone who swings an axe.
I do hear that a lot.
But baking is your only craft, is that right?
I have always enjoyed it. And I have always been good at it. But when I'm not able to find such work, I take odd jobs where I can. So long as I can work with my hands.
Well, we have that in common.
I know. But if you could stop fighting, what would you do?
You ask the wrong question. I can stop fighting. But to do so would be to deny the essence of who I am. I think you mean, if I had to stop fighting, what would I become?
No, you've given me the answer I wanted. It's good you found what calls for. A rare and happy thing.
Yes, yes, I see you both. What can I... It's you. Well, what are you doing in Mercia?
Collecting grain. 30 silver's worth, if you can spare it. I do have the coin.
Right. Well... take what you need and get going.
That should cover it. Thank you kindly.
Of course. And you, you take good care of yourself. Yeah?
Is that your usual vendor? He seemed a little surprised to see you.
Did he? Well, could be he knows somebody who looks like him. There's no shortage of big bearded men around here, yeah?
I suppose not. About your question earlier, what would I do if I weren't a warrior? I would ask the same of you. Is baking bread your greatest wish?
Is there something wrong with wanting to bake bread? The Romans baked bread. The Egyptians baked bread.
It is a fine trait. But is it your calling?
It is my calling to feed people, I'd say. To be of service to those I care for. And who care for me. That brings me joy.
Put that way, it is a noble pursuit.
I don't know that it's noble. It is simply what gets me up in the morning. It gives me purpose for the rest of my day.
Need help with your grain?
No need, no need. I'll do the rest myself. Bring it in and put it where I like.
All right. It was good to speak with you, Torben. A welcome diversion.
You too, Eivor. Thank you for your help.